So game number three is going to be right now up. So who's going to be advancing into the second round of, oh, another Alfheim? Isis and Loki. This time it's going to be Isis coming from the other side from Blood. And for what I've read in chat, and also I do seem to remember, he likes to be playing Aegis. I do remember from previous tournaments, he was playing set there. As well, Loki from Kiruda is actually fairly interesting, as he's going to be switching between Greek, Aegis, and right now into Agro God with the Norse. He's going to be choosing all three civilizations. Quite a bit interesting. And intriguing, definitely so. But, as I said and started saying, well, whoever's going to be losing this match is certainly not out of the tournament. Only the winner is going to be advancing into the second round of the winner bracket, but the loser will still be available in the loser's bracket, and that is how the qualification works. So that there's going to be potentially some chance to adjust to some maybe misunderstanding in the ratings and in the seedings, because obviously it's always hard to be seeding Titans players in Vanilla and vice versa. So I think it's making good sense to be having the qualification double elimination so that the top eight players are gonna be selected with some more prudency and more relevancy, and therefore the main stage of the tournament is going to be a lot more legit. Okay, we're gonna be having some relic for Trio of Helpful Monkeys, which could be actually fairly interesting, yet again, because you don't get any free spawns on the advance from the temple. So any kind of unit like that extra is going to be even more important. He's gonna be having still some chickens. Starting gold mine is not entirely too ideal for Blood. He's gonna have to somewhat work for that. He does have some kind of hill here, but nonetheless, I'm thinking something that might be still potentially abused. He's gonna have to drop a few buildings and some wall in into the front for the proper protection. There is a back TC here, sure, but yeah, well, yet again, Vanilla. No extra second TC in the classical age. Nope, you need to be at into fast heroic first. Arrows of the Alpha is gonna be quite an excellent relic. That's really awesome. And it would be really helpful to increase the damage of the TC, potentially towers, hill fort. And you don't have anything else here. Obviously, the dogs are not counting this time around. As to the left side, that will be just a bit of scouting by the Isis. And will be apparently moving quite a bit further away on the Aurochs. Interesting that he's not going through midst. Because I'm thinking this has been scouted by Red. I would be guessing so. But not really 100% positive. At any rate, he's gonna be on the left side. Already found out by the Ulfsak. So yeah, that's gonna be a clear deal here. Whereas, well, a bit more to the south, he's gonna be trying to find a few extra things here, if he can. Can he though? Because it seems like there's basically just a corner and a mountain. Nothing too extreme. That's gonna be also second TC to the right for Blood. She's gonna be kind of protecting the gold mine here. It's not too terrible. Gonna be able to wall off like this part of the map. So that's a reasonable combination. And the gold mine on the left side, actually the couple here, not really ideal, but I don't think it's too terrible either, because this is fairly close to the base, and it can be therefore dropping a migroll here somewhat in the heroic age. Potentially gonna be claiming the TC, mercenaries from it later. Yeah, I don't think it's too terrible. I think it's alright. Some kind of plans with that can be certainly had. Certainly so. Quite a bit certainly so. Now well, at any rate, as you're gonna be waiting for the advances, you had about 3:30. That's a lot of cows. That's seriously a lot of cows for Blood. When you compare it with Loki, that's actually a bit interesting that he managed to get so many of them. But you can see Kiruda is gonna be going quite a bit aggro. Interesting again. Interesting again. You can see he's gonna be having also the extra wolfie. I'm wondering if there's gonna be some kind of really fighting going on here. It's gonna be right now still out of line of sight. So looking forward if he's gonna be shift clicked into it, kill you die. Using the tree as part of the wall in here. No, I would be kinda careful because sometimes, no, we have seen a few weeks ago, I think in it was, that there was a bit of an interesting spot that maybe could have been actually passed through, but it seems like, yeah, he's just gonna be right now making sure of that, kill you die. He also wasn't certain about it. Yeah, I think this is prudent, just to be making sure. That was looking all kinds of funny, and you really don't want to be having surprises like that in the middle of a fight. Ooh, Tower of Cestus, right next to Arrows of the Alfar. Okay. Okay. It also kind of makes me think it would be kind of fun for a single player, definitely not for multiplayer, if actually relics of a certain kind could be combined together into some kind of like super relic and extra bonus. I'm thinking that for 1v1s and single player games, or not 1v1, single player games against AI to be actually incredibly fun and interesting game mode, but obviously for multiplayer not really, because that would be based way too much on luck. Way too much on luck. Yeah, Joe saying that he doesn't like the intensity of the vanilla game. Oh well, we definitely like him to see him as well. Tackle the vanilla players. Maybe gonna be seeing some matches here and there, who knows. And some fun games, some training games for others. As we have really plenty of Titans players participating, so it should be quite a good fun. Quite a good fun, and overall, you can find a list of players that have actually signed up on the exclamation mark winter. It's about like 30 plus players or how much. So you should be having quite a diverse set of games and gods and everything. But yeah, well, with the gods, it's gonna be ensured just by the rules of the tournament themselves. So Arngrim's stone border, or the stone border, is going to be right now coming forward for a bit of an early attack. Is he gonna be looking into barracks? Man, it's not really mean to play in rotating mode. I mean, like, having launched vanilla here and should be working normally. I actually don't remember if vanilla can be rotating on its own or if it was only edit. Legit don't recall. I'm probably looking at it in options. Hello, camera rotation, so it's in the vanilla. So, yeah, I'm entirely certain Gactus would die what you are right now meaning. That's a part of the vanilla game as well. As far as I can tell, therefore, it is. Maybe somebody proved me wrong, but yep, so far it seems to me that it's kind of done deal. But you can see it's gonna be still a good amount of hunt here, and to the right side, some extra batch of aurochs. They are going to be really available so far. And also the fourth relic that's gonna be here, and that is for Shingles of Steel for better house hit points. Actually not bad for the Norse, as they do have the lower hit points on their buildings, so keeping the houses alive a bit longer would be quite a bit helpful. Quite a bit helpful indeed. We do have, therefore, that was the one for the tower attack, right? Yeah, I'm thinking so, because the three others are still in, and he's still gonna be having some extra wolfies, some deer, some aurochs. I mean, like, really, Kiruda is having quite a good map, and overall he's controlling it also really well. That's the important part. Okay, gonna be having the armory for blood. So on the gold money is gonna be having still 2000. Plenty of food with husbandry, sure, on the cowies. It's gonna be alright. We are having already pickaxe. Then the base upgrades on the other side. We're gonna be having only hunting dogs and nothing else yet. As the volume is gonna be there for done, coming for the berries. Yet again, why not build it into the middle? But I guess everybody's preference. As the axeman will be heading for a bit of an assault. Or maybe kind of just assault on the villages if he's gonna be able to find them in the first place. But Hagrid doesn't like the cow location. Which one actually it was? And that is certain. Well, 2 minutes ago, no idea whatsoever. But maybe he's gonna be elaborating a bit longer or a bit later. But you can see that right about now, even for example, the wooden wall here, the chip, not entirely in the bestest of positions. So it's gonna be probably having to fix it a bit later, maybe. Who knows? Who knows? Absolutely, certainly, and indeed. But well, we're gonna be also maybe right now expecting that could be a bit of a chance for Kirudai to maybe even advance into heroic, because I'm thinking he's not building too many new units and he's still having excellent economy as far as, no, yeah, right now dropping the armory. That's exactly it. Keep having the correct feeling about the map and about how the game is proceeding. So that should be about maybe the same time, and I think he has blood. So right now he's also gonna be having quite a tons. Unfortunately, villagers gonna get in a bit blocked on their own. But yeah, well, that's how it usually is. Nothing that can be really done about that. Nothing that can be done. It's gonna be very important what kind of part of the map he's gonna be going for. If it's gonna be right now the TC and this gold mine, which is apparently quite excellently walled off, because it feels to me this is gonna be all the way through side of the map. Or if he's gonna be trying to move a bit more to the left side, drop a migdol here somewhere, maybe even a bit more aggressively, and try to get those gold mines, because I can see a merit in both. but mostly it's gonna be dependent on how well is Blood gonna be scouting, so I'll be liking him to maybe drop a few more obelisks in important places, maybe like here to have an idea what's going on, to the left side definitely, and to could be allowing him to really have a better idea about how to proceed. So only mediums, Ornolf is gonna be at Hall of Thanes already, with right now 5.72 speed for the Heresiers already. Neftis is going to be there for in. Still right flank, we're gonna be right now trying to wall off the map, which is not gonna be too extremely difficult for Blood and neither for Kirudai, as they're having pretty much like the same idea here. Pretty much the same idea. Oh, now that is an Age of Empires wall as if I ever saw one. Age of Empires 2 wall in right here. Let's take a screenshot of that. Yeah, well, gonna be having a different number than you are used to in Titans, because this is actually in different place. It's in the Age of Mythology install directory, not in the documents. So while there I have about like 1100 screenshots already in Titans, and here it's quite a bit lower. But we have, for example, priest with already funeral rites on them. Whereas, well, this is gonna be just a bit of an attempt to take down the tower, but without any kind of good effect here so much. And in the end, he chose to be going for the second option that he mentioned a bit earlier. That means going for the left side, which is gonna be giving him a bit more of an opportunity to develop into map control a bit more. He's gonna wait now getting the TC. The right side would be a bit more dependent on how the game will be proceeding after. That is absolutely certain, as you need to be looking into the engagement. Gonna be getting trolled. Flaming weapons actually kind of late, to be honest. Only after he started losing units. As right now, Ancestors and Eclipse are gonna be coming up. And that is kinda hard to see for me, what's actually right now going on. As it seems like the army is gonna be pretty much dead for Blood, as he's finishing with the settlement, but the Ancestors are still at least a bit there, but they will be right now demolished by the Heresiers, and it's gonna be time for Kirudai to still have 35 minutes of, or seconds rather, half a minute of the flaming weapons to have a look into the Migdol. Alright, so that's gonna be quite a bad news at this point for Blood. It's not terrible news. Still gonna be difficult to really demolish any kind of building or whatsoever. That really isn't simple at all for him still. That's gonna be quite nice micro with the Pharaoh. Noticing that immediate spawn and getting rid of the INAR. But there is also micro for Kirudai, who's trying to get into the Pharaoh. And now, oh, he's gonna be blocked there. Yep, he was already trying to go into the fortress. Into the Migdol, he's not gonna be able to do so, and there are still plenty of trolls and not entirely enough priests here just yet. Not ideal. Even right now the weapons are gone, this is gonna be also the battle boar coming forward as basically the destroyer of the buildings, and the gold mine is going to be denied. And while the TC is still here, this is certainly not boding all that powerful, but definitely isn't. Vyblade, also thank you very much for the follow a bit earlier. Hope we're gonna be having some fun with Age of Mythology, not only Vanilla today, as after a match is going to be done, this is the last deciding game, we're gonna be going for some community games. But here, it's really looking quite solid for kill, but still is definitely not over, as on the other side of the map, there is a gold mine for Blood that he can be using. On the upgrades, he's gonna be having Handaxe and Pickaxe, on the other side, still Hunt available with Pickaxe, and really, just having Hunt until 30 minutes and still having right now even some double deers with potentially even the wolfies having some, I don't know, bit of food on them, some chickens, some berries. He is definitely not in any kind of shortage of resources and still doesn't have to be committing to do farms all that badly, which is of course gonna be helping him commit with the resources into attack. You can see right now the three golden monkeys. Only 40 hit points, but still 5 extra attack, so basically effectively 15 extra attack, why not? Why not? Every kind of little bit and piece like that is gonna be insanely helpful. So it seems like the left side of the map is gonna be fully under control of Kirudai, whereas the right flank, that's gonna be a gold mine, still 5000, which is fine. Maybe there could be some move forward into this gold and even into the TC, not really sure. But it's not gonna be anything simple at all, because you can see that the army is quite limited. He's not going to be having the new Migdol yet. Nope. No new Migdol so far. So he's going to be having to right now survive on the Spearman and potentially Axeman, which certainly doesn't exactly bode all that well for him, considering the army that opposing side is having, and especially looking at all the picks. But needs to be somehow getting into the priest so that they can be that he can be keeping those basic siege weapons at this point alive a bit longer. Okay, wait a bit longer. Okay, Vali's Silverface is gonna be at this point at no upgrades whatsoever. On the other side, it's gonna be the Chariot Archer's Blood without any kind of upgrade, which is not really surprising. You can see second piggy gone, but there is gonna be a lot of replacement coming. Still plenty of piece, new ones still coming up all the time. But problem is that right now with only two barracks, he's not gonna be able to spam enough units, and still the mythical units right now keep getting spawned, and it's really hard to react to for Blood, and it seems to me he might not be exactly able to have enough time for all that. Especially since he's right now having to be using the priest to fight even against horses, which is not entirely too terrible, but with all the towers right now gone, it's gonna be two gone, third one and... yeah, third one and fourth one. Okay, there's still one more here to the top. That's yeah, the tenth to be, and can be spawning all kinds of funny here. On the Valiant maps, it's not entirely an army that you want to be relying upon in the game. So far, we don't exactly see any kind of massive movement for Kirudai as far as some kind of like military buildings close by to the enemy too much, only those two long houses, which can be already kind of enough, it seems to me. Seems to me quite a little bit. And Shelty, yes, that I see you here, that's a good point. I also wanted to be making sure that we're gonna be casting your selected game, and you're gonna be here. This is looking like an excellent opportunity before you're gonna be switching over into the Titans. So yeah, you're gonna be doing it right after a match. Definitely will. Okay, so that was a bit of an attempt to maybe just block the path here as well a bit. Maybe a bit surprising, he didn't try to take the TC, as it would be better protection than anything else. Okay, like a bit better protection indeed, as it's gonna be there for right now, destruction of the piggy for sure, but nonetheless, maybe could be using a few more of the villagers for a bit of really fighting, so that he kills them basically earlier, and therefore doesn't then, yeah, exactly doesn't this happen. Can't be getting exactly big into the middle of the fight. Oh well, bit of a sad story. It's gonna be easily killed, sure, but it's gonna be eating a lot of damage, and therefore it's gonna be more opportunity for Kirudai to get in a bit more units into the fight and get rid of the priests. As the GG is gonna be there for already called, and we are gonna be resigning with them so that we have the same statistics mostly. And it's going to be therefore victory for Kirudai, who's gonna be in the premier match of Aeol Destroyer's Vanilla Winter Tournament 2021, winning and advancing into the second round of the winner's bracket of the qualification. But as I said, and as I repeated many times, Blood is absolutely not certainly out. He is going to be playing in the loser's bracket still in the qualification, and he has all the chances to be going forward into the main stage of the tournament still. But he's gonna be having to, at this point, go for a bit of a hardcore run, whereas Kirudai is still gonna be having the safety net behind him in case he loses in the next rounds. But we have seen an excellent match, and definitely quite a bit worthy one, between Titan Skiller proving his worth also in Vanilla, and Vanilla Skill Brat, or the Blood, who certainly did mount quite a nice comeback after the first game and did quite what he could have to maybe even get the victory himself. Okay, so that's gonna be therefore a done deal for the first match. And again, thanks to Aeol Destroyer for hosting the Vanilla tournament for us, and also to all others, for example today Rebels with Ippert, and also Hagrid on making some last day adjustments to make the patch and the maps work exactly as they should be. So that is going to be therefore a done deal here. Let's look into the post game, and then we're gonna be heading into, well, Shelty's recorded game that he basically bought with channel points a few weeks ago, 2 weeks ago I think it was. So he should be having some interesting match. I think it was Shelty versus Squash in that match, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, so that's gonna be it now. Kirudai with, no, of course, the highest score for everything. Quite nice Norse aggro and Loki aggro to be precise coming up. Can see having the resources quite a bit higher, 2, 4, and 3, maybe, or 2, like 6,000 to 7,000 resources more for Kirudai. Yeah, that's something that you're gonna be noticing. Can see right now even the civilians, 56, 43, everything going rather well, and the flamer weapons, yep, Ancestors and Eclipse, unfortunately, against Loki, and it's where it's not gonna be heading into anything too awesome, unless you're gonna be able with your normal army to single out the Hersers in some higher manner and higher way and amount and everything. As a different word I wanted to say, just cannot recall which one. Cannot recall at all. It's going to be 7 trolls here. Yeah, well, he got really a lot of them into spawn. He also got a decent amount of INARs. Only later he started getting a few piggies. But yeah, well, it's random, so simply Ghost decided what he's gonna be getting, and that's what he was having preordained for him. Now, so on the civilians, fairly similar, just a bit of a job here. There was some small raid by Kirudai on the hunt through top, but then a bit later, that was the game decider. And he was able to beat the army, beat the ancestors, and then also occupy the Migdol that simply Blood wasn't able to replace. You can see it now, the drop into the depths of the graph, and there was simply wasn't any kind of comeback from that. Okay, congratulations to Kirudai on the victory, and good job to Blood for quite an excellent match, and good luck further in the qualification for both of them, as both of them are going to be continuing. Kirudai in winner's bracket, Blood in loser's bracket. GG.